a lot, and I'm someone who's very passionate about math and biology. I love to learn about the intersection of how math can be applied to solve biological problems, and I love to explore this intersection through research. I had always kind of loved math from a young age, but I guess the moment when I really began to appreciate not only like the thrill of competition math, but also just like the beauty of learning math and exploring math itself was when I first went to a math camp called Math Path, and this was in Minnesota. But I went to this math camp and I met many like incredible mathematicians, and I began to realize like math and science and all of this is about community, and it's about collaboration as well as competition. And that was when I also began to appreciate like the deeper elegance of mathematical thinking and problems as well. Math requires you to be very rigorous and very logical, and that kind of extended to how I interpreted things like biology or like physics, where like I approach a problem and I think about it in like quantitative manners. For example, like a cell. When I started learning about cell biology, one of the first things that I wondered was like, how can we think about a cell in a quantitative manner, and how can we use numbers to model these very complex biological systems? So from math, I kind of gained this quantitative, like rigorous, logical way of thinking about questions that are not inherently mathematical. And I think that kind of contributed a lot to how my research and how my passions developed. So in between like 11th and 12th grade, I applied to this program called the Research Science Institute, and this was like a dream of mine for such a long time. Like I'd always wanted to attend RSI or the Research Science Institute. So when I applied, I wrote about my passions for math and biology. In my project, basically what I did is I created a new computational tool, which I call RiboBase. And basically what it does is it looks at large volumes of biological data generated from living cells, and it identifies these very important sites within the genome, which is like all of the genes within our human body, called ribosome pause sites. And what it does with these ribosome pause sites is it tells researchers, like in disease states, for example, a cancer cell, like how do these ribosome pause sites behave differently as opposed to a regular cell. During RSI, we had this time when like some DoD professionals did come and talk to us, and I guess like what really surprised me and kind of touched me the most was like how human the DoD like STEM department is. It's just a lot of very incredible people who are very passionate about bringing STEM education to as many aspiring young scientists in America like as possible. And I think it's just a very like inspiring goal, and something that I'm very happy to see that our government is like investing into the STEM education of younger scientists. And I think it's just something that's very important and inspiring. My advice for like anybody who's interested in STEM, math and biology, anything like that, is just find something that you're very passionate about that really calls to you and that you feel like is something you really love, and go very deep in that field.